Hey guys, Matt here from MK-SmartHouse.com, and in this video, I'm going to show you how to build the blinds control. So in this video, we're going to go over all the parts required for the blinds control, and then we're going to make it. To start off with the parts, we're going to need one 2-pin PCB terminal, one 4-pin female header, one 3-pin male header, one 3-pin terminal, one 2-pin jumper, one ESP8266, one 5-volt to 3.3-volt regulator, one custom blinds control PCB, more on that later, one plastic enclosure, 10 feet of 2-conductor 22-gauge cable, one male USB connector, one servo adapter plate, one servo motor, four servo to blinds adapter screws, one adapter plate screws, two servo mount screws, 6 feet of servo motor cable, one set of servo motor connectors, one servo motor blinds adapter, one servo motor mount, and a powerful 5-volt wall adapter. The wall adapter can be any USB 5-volt adapter like a phone charger. Just make sure it is powerful because the servo motor takes more power than the other things we have made in the past. You may have noticed that the servo to blinds adapter and the servo mount are not normal parts. That is because they are 3D printed parts. To get these parts, you can either 3D print them yourself with the STL files on my website, or you can buy the parts from my website. For tools, we're going to need a soldering iron with ST7 tip, flux, steel wire, solder, PCB holder, helping hands, wire strippers, small wire cutters, small flat screwdriver, Phillips screwdriver, Dremel, and a hot glue gun. That is everything that we will need. The links to all the parts and tools will be over on my website. Link is in the description. On my website, you will also find the kit for this device. So instead of buying all the parts separately, you can buy one kit and get all the parts fast and at the same time. There's even an option to get the device assembled. So all you would have to do is install the software and set it up. In the beginning, I did say custom circuit board because to make this easier, I designed a custom circuit board so that way not only will it be very stable and have strong connections with no guesswork in assembling it, but also so I can make many of them really easily for my house. I provided the Gerber file on my website as well as where to get it made. You can also buy the PCBs on my website, which is the easiest and fastest way to get them. Since all the connections are already made on the circuit board, all we have to do is solder the components onto the board. First, let's take the circuit board and put it into the circuit board holder. If you look closely at the circuit board, you will see that there are labels next to the component slots. When I say where to put the component, that is what I'll be referring to. I like to solder from the less sensitive components to the most sensitive. So let's start with the 2-pin terminal. Take the terminal and put it into J1. Then solder it in. If you want to know how to solder or how I solder, then check out my guide for the door sensor because in that video I went over in detail. After that, take the 3-pin screw terminal and put it into J4. Next, take the 4-pin female header and put it into J2 and solder it in. If the leads get long and stick out, cut them with the wire cutters. Then take a strip of the male header and using the wire cutters, make a header that is 3 pins long. Take that 3-pin male header and solder it into J3. For slot U2, take the 5-volt to 3.3-volt regulator and match up its leads to the board and solder it in. Before we flip over the PCB, we're going to put the 2-pin jumper on the 3-pin male header and above the PGM side. Great, now we have one component left to solder, and that is the ESP8266. It is on the back of the PCB, so flip it over. I recommend putting flux on every single pad of the ESP8266 and the circuit board and then solder it in. Next, we're going to work on the power cable to the device. Then take one end of the wire, strip it to expose the two conductors. Strip a little of each conductor and then take the wire boot and plastic boot of the USB connector and slide it over the two conductors. Next, take the helping hands and put the 22 gauge wire in one of them and the USB connector in the other. Then solder the black wire to the far left pin and the red wire to the far right pin. Now put some hot glue on the connector and slide over the plastic boot. And if you want, you can connect the USB to 5-volt wall adapter, but do not plug it into power. Almost done. Strip the other end of the 22 gauge cable and then loosen the two screws on the 2-pin terminal above 5 volts. Then take the red wire and put it into the hole parallel to where it says plus and the black into the hole above the the minus symbol and tighten the screws. Next, grab the servo motor cable and cut it to a length of 6 feet. Take the cable and separate the individual wires and strip them to expose the conductors. Next, grab the pieces to the servo motor connector. Separate one of the male metal pieces and put the orange wire into it. Repeat the same steps for the other two wires. Once the wires are complete, stick them into the black plastic piece of the connector. Now our male connector is done. Take the other end of the servo motor cable, separate the wires, strip them, and fold back their leads. Then loosen the 3-pin terminal screws on the PCB. Put the brown wire into the minus slot, red into the plus slot, and then the orange wire into the D slot. Once those are in, tighten their screws down. Next, grab the main part of the servo mount and place the servo motor onto it. Secure the servo motor by taking the two servo mount screws and screwing them in with a Phillips screwdriver. You may need to file down some of the edges of the servo mount in order for the spacers to fit. After that, grab the servo adapter plate and put the black adapter plate screw into it. Now take the servo to blends adapter and put the side with no screw holes down onto the table. You may need to file down the square of the adapter in order for the blinds shaft to fit into it. Then put the adapter plate on top of that and screw it down using the four servo to blinds adapter screws. Grab the plastic enclosure and put the blinds control into the enclosure. Now take the servo coupler that comes with the servo connector and put both the male servo connector and the female servo connector into the coupler. Finally, since the servo motor is really wide, it will not fit into the blinds. So grab a Dremel and cut off the tabs of the other side of the servo motor. Once everything is done, we should have the following things: power cable connected to the blinds control, the blinds control box with lid, servo motor cable connected to the servo motor and on the servo mount, servo mount spacers, and the servo to blinds adapter connected to the servo plate. We will attach that in the final installation video. That is it for the hardware of the actual device. Now all it needs is some software, which will be in the next video. If you need any of the parts shown in the video, you can buy a kit, the PCB, or 3D printed parts to make the device at the link in the video description. Alright, thank you for watching. If you have any questions, leave them in the comment section below, or head over to mksmarthouse.com/forum. Goodbye.